Half a dozen on one side, six on the other. That is what I think you could say about the John Wall Russell Westbrook trade, but hey, let's explore it together and see if there are any real winners. Greetings and salutations, sports fans. Thanks for checking in with us once again here at The Fumble. I'm your host, Jackie Ray. Make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell, give this video a thumbs up, and then head on over to Twitter and Instagram and follow me at JRayTheFanatic. First of all, happy holidays. I hope you guys are all doing great and wonderful in this pandemic holiday season. So what do you really want during this holiday season? For a while there, people started assuming that James Harden wanted a new teammate and wanted Russell Westbrook out of Houston. It was interesting that these rumors began circulating after Russell Westbrook was traded to the Washington Wizards. Because before that, the rumors all said that both James Harden and Russell Westbrook wanted out. Part of the reason was their disdain for the Houston Rockets owner. According to NBA reporter Rich Bercher, Ferretta's Republican donations and support for the current president did not sit well with either superstar. But if that's true, the rumors that James Harden was adamant to go to the Brooklyn Nets, that doesn't make sense either, because their owner also donated and supports the current president. And honestly, if that was the reason, while understandable, that would eliminate a lot of teams. So what's your option at that point? So maybe the old saying is true. The devil you know is better than the devil you don't, which means that maybe head coach Steven Silas had the best idea. He said his goal was to give Harden some space and hope that he would realize what the team was doing to keep him and that it would result in James Harden being all in. Player movement is really kind of par for the course for James Harden. He brought in Chris Paul, he didn't like that, shipped him out. He brought in Russell Westbrook, he didn't like that, maybe he's shipping him out too. And according to Adrian Woj, James Harden prefers to play with John Wall. Really? A 30-year-old point guard who hasn't played since 2018 because of serious injuries, including an Achilles tear? He's the missing piece for James Harden? Is it possible that it will never matter what James Harden does or who he plays with? If he stays on a team or if he goes, maybe it doesn't matter because maybe it is him who is the problem. That is the question a lot of you were asking on Twitter. This user said, just like how Russ was a better fit than CP3, according to him. Russ wanted a change in the system, which would have required Harden giving up the ball, and he shipped him out just like CP. If you don't bow down to Kim Jong Harden, he'll have you traded. He's the real problem. This user said he is going to keep having preferences till he gets the chip. Sad thing is, he don't realize he is the problem. Two ball dominant. How is Wall going to play off him? Wall not the best shooter to be off ball. And finally, this user said, Houston is stuck. They made Harden the cornerstone and now everything revolves around him. Pieces continue to shift, but there will never be no progress until the franchise pivots away from him. That's actually not a bad notion. And I've actually thought that for a while, but I thought Harden should pivot away from the Rockets. James Harden has been with the Rockets since 2012, and to what end? His first season, they were booted out of the first round by Russell Westbrook and Kevin Durant and the OKC Thunder. In 2014, they lost to Dame Dalla and the Trailblazers in the first round. 2015 did seem like their best chance, and they made it to the Western Conference Finals, where they lost to the Golden State Warriors. 2016, lost in the first round to the Warriors again. The next year, they lost in the semifinals to the Spurs, lost in the Western Conference Finals to Golden State again, then lost in the second round again to the Warriors, and they lost to the Lakers just last season. If the goal is to get the chip, all those playoff appearances and no real shot would have to be frustrating. But it is always a risk when you go somewhere else, unless you go to a situation like KD did with the Warriors, where they are a perfectly oiled machine and you're just kind of little sprinkles on the top. Sure, KD and Harden have played together before, but so did Harden and Westbrook. That didn't work. And with KD and Kyrie having never played together and both coming off major injuries, it would be a huge risk to just pack up and head east. Yes, Houston did fall completely apart, but sometimes that's exactly what you need to do to build something that's better. To be fair, John Wall is in his prime. He's a five-time All-Star and one of the best creators of offense in the game. Depending on how he comes back from his injury, he will no doubt be an asset to the Rockets. But he has never been an efficient scorer or an intimidating three-point shooter. No, he hasn't. There is never any assurances that an athlete will come back and be the same athlete or even better when they left from an injury. And John Wall's injury report is very, very long. Besides a left knee injury in 2012 and a right knee issue in 2015 and 2016 and a procedure on both knees in 2016, he missed a large portion of the 2017-2018 season after having another procedure on his left knee. Then in his 2018-2019 season, he ended early with surgery on his left heel, followed by a ruptured left Achilles tendon after falling at home. The last time John Wall played an NBA game was December 26, 2018. Even though he is getting rave reviews from players who have practiced with him, I am still not convinced. Even if he comes back better than expected from his nearly two-season layoff, is he really that much different than Russell Westbrook? People will always argue that Russell Westbrook has an ego, and I will ask you, where is the proof of that? Before joining the Clippers, Paul George told reporters that he thought the pairing of James Harden and Russell Westbrook would work. He said, quote, "Russ is a winner. Russ wants to win. Russ does whatever it takes to win. My time playing with him, Russ doesn't really have an ego. He puts his ego to the side." Russ has even gone so far to not allow reporters to blame other teammates for falling short because he wants to move as a team. He always seems to be a leader and he always wants to support those around him. Does that sound like an ego to you? Now, James Harden did relegate himself to the guy who would just hang out beyond the arc and wait for the ball whenever Westbrook was controlling the ball, but that seems like more of a coaching problem to me than a Russell or James Harden problem. So really, when it comes down to it, the contributions between John Wall and Russell Westbrook are similar. However, I do think John Wall is somewhat of a downgrade. Kind of. Because it's never a bad idea to do whatever you can to keep your star player, especially if by keeping him, you are bringing an asset who is fully capable of leading a team. But Houston seemed not only committed to keeping James Harden, but also to building a better team. In addition to the trade for Wall, the Rockets made other moves to improve the supporting cast around Harden, such as free agent additions of Chris Wood and DeMarcus Cousins, which means that Houston is proving that they want to do more than just play small ball. And for that reason, I think this is a win for Houston either way. And I believe Paul George. Russell Westbrook is not as nearly as selfish as a lot of you make him out to be. I think he and Bradley Beal are going to work incredibly well together and that Russ won't have any problem helping Beal become the center point of that franchise, especially if it means the possibility of achieving the ultimate goal. So like I said, half a dozen on one side, six on the other, I think this is a fair trade between these two franchises. But what do you think? Who was the real winner in the John Wall trade? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Once again, I'm Jackie Ray. Happy holidays, and thanks for watching The Fumble.